What's up? We're Fallout Boy.
And this is Tour Exposed on VEVO.
A look behind the curtains of touring with us.
This is our home, away from home. Life on a tour bus, you know, up is down, left is right. You really make up your own rules.
Laws of physics are reversed here.
One of the biggest conceptions that people come in with is this idea that wouldn't you rather be in a hotel? And it's like, no, because every day you'd have to unpack and every day you have to live out of the suitcase. Whereas like here, you have your spot, you have your bunk. This is the breakfast table. That's like where we sit and watch TV.
Right now we're out on a small tour supporting, say, rock and roll in the US, doing clubs. But we're really excited to take the show this fall out into arenas.
We seem to have a vision of what we want to do, and I think that's really exciting.
Those of you watching will have to go to the show to see what crazy, wacky stuff we do, but it'll be a lot of fun.
What's up? This is Marcus, head of security. He basically is our tour nanny. Make sure we get from place to place and leave on time.
Worked for Fall Out Boy for over 7 years now. They're cranksters and practical jokers, especially Pete. You know, he's done things to me like started a fake Marcus Johnson Twitter account.
This is Brian Diaz. He is stage left guitar tech, both guitar and bass. And he basically makes sure the show keeps running on this side of the stage and is my oldest friend on the crew.
How did I end up here?
is this a dream or a nightmare?
I'm usually up and running in about 30 to 45 minutes. Line check is the crew's time to kind of go through every single thing on the stage and make sure that it's working right. Fall Out Boy opened for my old band in 2003. There'd be 100 people there and 75 of them would be there to see Fall Out Boy. They'd leave after they played and they were opening for us. And I was like, yeah, sure, you don't want to like play after us.
So we're now at front of house. And up first we have Rob, who's handling the lights and visuals for this tour. And this one is probably where I do the most tinkering.
I put together the show, come up with how it's gonna look conceptually. I work a lot with, in this particular instance, Pete, to figure out what we want each song to look like, color themes, you know, the actions of lighting in the show. Pete's very clear on, you know, what he likes and what he doesn't like, so that's awesome.
And right next door, we have Brent. Brent is the audio engineer, mm-hmm. as well as production manager.
Mm-hmm. I'm typically the first person into the venue, and I'm one of the last people to leave. As a production manager, I kind of oversee the crew more than I do the artist. Also, I'm the front of house engineer, so I mix the band's performance. So when you go to a show and you hear it, if it's either good or it's bad, I'm the guy that's responsible for how it sounds.
Hello. This is the support act for the tour. New Politics, who it's cool. We feel lucky that we got a chance to get this band.
We got the call from our management and said, you guys are going on with Fall Out Boy, and we all freaked out.
And we're so excited. We've been 6 days in the tour. The energy is amazing. The fans, it's like magical. And they're great. They take us in with open arms. It's been amazing.
Watching Fall Out Boy and then, you know, watching us, it's a good combination.
See you guys at sound check.
Absolutely.
All right. Okay.
The Youngblood Chronicles are this idea we had to do. We're gonna do a song, a video for every song. The idea is to create a narrative that arcs through the whole album. And live, we've been using footage that we shot for the Phoenix video. The story represents just another creative element that's coming from this album.
It's great to be back on the road and playing new songs. It's reinvigorating. For me personally, it gives me a chance to kind of mess with a bunch of new cool guitar toys.
Fans are awesome, and they're definitely the reason to do it. And for them to embrace an album we made just for ourselves is awesome.
I love the small venues for the energy. I mean, you're just so close to kids. You see kids sing along, you can hear them sing along right in front of you.
I think every member kind of warms up in their own way. I like to just get inside my own head. I don't like to have a ton of people around outside of the band.
I have like a specific, you know, warm-up that I go through. And I've actually been noticing that it's taking a little bit longer than it should, so sorry if any fans have been noticing that we've been a little bit late, it's me.
Mm-hmm. Thanks for joining us for our episode of Tour Exposed on VEVO. Now we're gonna go play a rock show.